Hey guys, this is a video review for The Crane's Wife, which is a book by Patrick Ness, and it's basically a retelling of an old Japanese folk tale. So the whole thing starts off with this dude named George Duncan who wakes up because he needs to go pee, but he can't but hear all these weird noises that are coming out of his back garden. So he goes to check it out and he basically finds a crane, a white crane that is injured, and he ends up helping it. The next day, this Japanese woman enters his shop by the name of Komiko. I hope I say it right. I'm not sure how you pronounce that, but she enters his shop, and from there the whole thing starts off basically. So both of them basically hit it off from the get-go and they start collaborating on these pieces of art that Komiko was working on, which basically George like adds to these pieces of art, and they become extremely popular and they obtain a lot of wealth and a certain amount of fame because of it. So George's relationship with Komiko basically develops extremely fast, and he can't help but having this nagging feeling of wanting to know more about her and wanting more of her, and this basically has huge repercussions for the rest of the story. But George isn't the only focal point of this book. You have his daughter Amanda, which is going through a lot of issues with her relationships, with her social relationships and her ex-husband and all of these things. And Komiko, again, somehow plays a large role in her life. So throughout the book, the legend is basically told in 32 parts as you read along. And it's not, to my knowledge, the same as the original Japanese folktale itself. It has been altered in this book. The writing style was quite different from Patrick Ness's YA books, but I found that I enjoyed it a lot. I thought the characters were likable. But here is when I talk about the negatives. To me, the main problem with this book is that the message seemed muddled and lost between what is happening in George's life and what's happening in Amanda's life in the book and the telling of the folktale itself. I thought that the larger message wasn't a clear large message, but there were like a lot of smaller messages that weren't well defined. So I gave this book 3 out of 5 stars. I didn't enjoy it as much as his other works, so to me it's a pass. Like, you don't really need to read this book if you're a fan of Patrick Ness, but it's okay. So yeah, if you guys like this video, press that like button and subscribe to my channel, and I'll see you guys later.